Begin self-publishing episode number 103. Writing in a foreign language with Helena Helmy.
Interested in self-publishing but don't know where to start? Want to get your book onto Amazon? Want to hold your paperback book in your hands? Learn how on the Begin Self-Publishing podcast with your host, Tim Lewis.
I've met Helena quite a few times over the years. She's been involved with the Alliance Independent Authors, and she's a Finnish author who's been living in London for the last few years. However, all of her books are written in English rather than in Finnish. And I thought it would be interesting to talk to somebody whose native language isn't English about how that process works. So now over to the interview. Hi, Helena. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Tim.
So I've got you on today because obviously you're a Finnish writer who's been writing in English. Why did you first decide to write in English rather than Finnish?
Well, I'd studied English at school in Finland since I was 7. And then when I was in my teens, pre-teens, in fact, we moved to Sweden and then I learned Swedish. And then when we moved back to Finland, when I was quite a lot older in my teens, I sort of was a bit mixed about my languages and I had to relearn Finnish. So I've always been I've always studied and spoken in several languages. So when I then moved to the UK at the age of 23, as a sort of newly married Navy wife, very naive and very young, I started writing a diary. I'd always written a diary anyway. So I started writing a diary, but it became very difficult to describe what was happening to me in Finnish because everything was in English. So I turned to a very sort of golden notebook by Doris Lessing, where he turned the book around and started writing in English on the other side. And I just haven't looked back. The Finnish sort of was left. I didn't even write any Finnish diary entries, I don't think, after that. And that's how I sort of began writing in English. Then I worked for the BBC as a journalist and a translator, and I obviously sort of learned English, better pronunciation and sort of expression at the BBC. And then 2003, when I'd written a novel and thought it was absolutely excellent, I decided that I was going to take an MA in creative writing. That novel will never see the day of light because it's terrible. So I took an MA in creative writing, and just to really sort of convince myself that I could write in English. And so I took that in 2003. And since then, I've written 6 novels.
Okay.
And I'm my 7th. Yeah. So it just comes naturally to me. I couldn't write in any other language at all now.
Okay. So how much do you think not having grown up in an English culture has hampered you in your writing?
Well, not being a native speaker, I sort of think of it more as an opportunity rather than a threat. Because I think that, my readers and my reviewers tell me that I've got a very Nordic or very sort of sparse style of writing, which I don't think I would have had if English was my mother tongue. And I also, because when I worked as a journalist and translator, it sort of taught me a lot about the use of English. So in a way, I think it's a good thing, because also my books are set in Finland. So I don't really consider it hampers me in any way at all, actually. Sometimes some things are difficult to find, like proverbs or prepositions are sometimes difficult to tell, but then I find that English people can't do that either. So, yeah, I sometimes think of when I watch Agatha Christie's Poirot, and he always gets his, mixes his metaphors, he always gets, the proverbs wrong and stuff like that. And I really have sympathies for him because I know exactly how it feels. And people just either puzzled or laugh at him, and I feel very sorry for him. But anyway, so I guess that's the only downside, but I don't feel it as a downside at all, actually.
Okay, so I suppose from looking at your novels, they seem to be very much based on your own experience, on your own life, and largely based in Finland. So
yes.
It probably means that you're not restricted by having to wonder about particular facets of, say, British society, because your book's just not set here. So I suppose that helps in a way.
The latest books in the series are, the one I'm writing now is actually set in London in the 1990s, so more than it is in Finland, but the main character is Finnish. So I can do it from her point of view, which, I know what I'm doing there, so that sort of helps. And I I've just taken, actually, because I'm applying for, after 33 years in the country, I'm applying for UK citizenship, and I've just taken the life in the UK test. And when I was sort of quizzing people around me, people didn't have a clue about the questions, so, and I passed. So I really don't think there is much of a difference. If you've lived in a country as long as I have, I think that, you know, there isn't an awful lot is different from, you know, with you and people around you.
Okay. So what would you say is the biggest difficulty you've faced in writing in English?
I think it is the proverbs and the sayings, you know, because I know there is one, but I can't think of it. So Google is wonderful. I use a lot of Google. And I always have a native speaker who reads my work first, and we work through it quite a few revisions, and then before it goes to an editor. So I don't, mind you, I have written 6 books, you know. The first one was fairly difficult, I guess. But because I've never been a native speaker really in any language, I mean, I don't feel like I'm a native speaking in Finnish anymore because my Finnish is so poor now that I don't really feel that I'm not English. That sounds crazy, but I've lived here longer than I lived anywhere else. So it just, it's a strange, I'm a strange animal, I think. That's the only thing to say.
So more generally, I mean, obviously you've been here for quite a long time, but let's say somebody who's listened to this, who their native language isn't English, but they're fairly competent in it. Do you think they need to spend more time on editing than a native English speaker would?
Oh, definitely. Yes. I mean, that's, having said all what I said before, you definitely do. I do believe that everybody needs to edit a lot longer than they think they're going to, but, you know, anyway. But yes, I do. As I said, I have a native speaker who checks it, and then I correct it, and then he checks it again. And so we work on it quite a lot before it even goes to my editor for the first edit. So, yes, I think you do. But as I said, it's one of those things that you either prefer doing or you don't. But as a non-English speaker or a non-native speaker, obviously you need to edit more with the native speaker. Yeah.
Okay. So I suppose the question is, well, what advice do you have for somebody who is wishing to write in their non-native language? And presumably we're kind of saying English from your experience point of view, but
yes indeed. Well, I mean, I would say that this checking and rechecking and the grammar and the spelling and the proverbs and all that sort of prepositions and all that sort of stuff is very important. You have to write first. You have to write the sort of the worst draft, which is always rubbish, as everybody says, and you have to let yourself go and let yourself write. But after that, I think you do have to be very careful with checking the grammar and with the native speaker. I also read only in English. I've had to give up reading in Swedish and Finnish because I do find that sort of messes with my head, if you like. And I start sort of changing the word order and stuff like that when I'm writing. So I have to be very careful that I only read in English. I also, if people are coming, family and friends come over from Finland, that tends to set me back a few weeks. It's a really weird thing. It's almost like you have to abandon your native land. And also, but the positives, as I said before, you can use your foreignness as a positive. All my books are set in Finland. They are all sort of from a multicultural point of view. So you look at England from the outside rather than from the inside, which is also always an advantage to have a different point of view. And as I said, it's really important to have a native speaker as your first reader. But having said all of that, be confident, because the only person who can tell that story is you. And what your experience, if it's different from anybody else's, then you will bring something different to the table, which means that your book will stand out. So I think it's really important to be confident, but at the same time, be aware that you do need to be a little bit more careful than a native speaker.
Okay. I'm going to throw you a bonus question.
Are you?
Yes. let's say we've got somebody who's listening in Finland and they actually want to write in Finnish.
Yeah.
Now, you've probably been asked this question. I don't know. I presume you've talked in Finland and other places.
I have, yeah.
Are there any special difficulties with somebody who actually wants to self-publish in a language like Finnish, which isn't necessarily that mainstream? And obviously, I don't think there's a Finnish Amazon store.
Actually, there isn't yet, but there are rumours that because Amazon has actually been recruiting in the Nordic countries. So there is definitely going to be an Amazon in Nordic countries, but every time I ask the question, they say, oh, we don't know. But you can still publish on Amazon.com, even though you're in Finland, and you can publish in Finnish, which people do. There are also ebook stores in Finland, and there is also, I'm trying to think of it, because you didn't tell me you're going to ask this.
I think Kobo's in Finland, because I think somebody bought my book in Finland once. So.
Yes, you can buy them through Amazon.com, and there are ebook stores in Finland, which are just Finnish ebook stores. But Finns have always sold paper pulp. It's been a big export item in Finland. We have lots of forests. At one time, the Times was made out of Finnish paper. So for Finns, paper books are very important. And so there's very little ebook sales. Ebook sales are really, really low in Nordic countries. And I think it is growing. But that's the reason Amazon hasn't been there yet. But it will be soon, I'm sure. I'm confident of that. But there are ways of self-publishing through different companies. And I'm trying to think of the name of the company. Bonniers, I think, have launched a new service. And I can't think of it now. But you can publish through them. But I would really recommend Amazon.com because it will reach more people than any other service.
Okay. So how can people find out about Helena Halmi and her books?
Well, I'm on my website is helenahalmi.com, very easy to remember. And I'm also on Facebook with that same name, on Twitter, on Instagram, and on LinkedIn and Pinterest, and Amazon.com or Amazon.co.uk, any of those. And you just type in Helena Halmi and you can see all my books there. I've just come out with a box set, actually, of the books so far. So that's novel 1, 2, and 3 in the series, and that's on sale now for a very reasonable price of
$3.99. Oh, you're doing a box set for $3.99. That's
actually, it's a very good price. Yeah, because I think it's 50% cheaper than if you bought all three books separately. So that's out today. So that's It's out on Amazon now, and it's done quite well actually. Yeah, it's.
Is that a promotional price of $3.99, or is it? Or is this going to be permanently at $3.99?
It's permanently $3.99, yeah.
Okay, so
$4.99, but £3.99.
Oh, so, okay, yeah.
Yeah, so, $4.99, yeah, so we're talking about UK pounds.
People listening to this show way in the future will be able to buy it at that price. Well,
yes, they will,
not
yes.
50 years in the future.
No, not 50 years, no. But yes, that's its permanent fixed price. But it's a good holiday read.
Okay.
Well, I've been told.
Thanks very much for being on the show, Helena.
Thank you, Tim, for inviting me. It's been fun.
Yeah.
Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed today's show, please stop by iTunes and rate and leave a review. This helps make the show more visible. For free resources, show notes, and other helpful content, join the community at BeginSelfPublishing.com.